Good afternoon, students. We are now going to discuss the next topic in centrifugal compressor, that is velocity diagram and velocity triangle analysis. So this centrifugal compressor is basically the radial outward flow turbo machine in which air is flowing from inner side of the compressor to the outer side, radial direction. So it's a radially outward flow turbo machines. We can consider over here, this is the impeller vanes and this is a diffuser vanes. So as per the basic concept of the velocity triangle in turbo machine, we have to draw the velocity triangles across the impeller vanes at inlet and outlet. At inlet side, it's called as the inlet velocity triangle, and outlet side it is called as the outlet velocity triangle. The similar diagram I have shown over here also. Okay. So at the inner side, that air get enter into the centrifugal compressor when suction pressure is created due to rotation of the impeller in radial direction or perpendicular direction with a V1 velocity with a no whirling component. Whirling component of velocity physically indicates the whirling motion of the air or fluid. In this case, this is the air, so it's called as a whirling motion of the fluid or air. Means the motion of the fluid particles around its axis, or we can call it as small eddies also. Okay, it is not expected to form eddies at the inner side. So air is get inside in a fine streamline of the fluid or air particles. So air enter in the impeller vane of the compressor with a velocity component V1, which also called as then V1 is equal to V1, means then alpha is equal to 90 degree, we know that V1 is equal to V1 and whirling component is equal to 0. Okay, now the impeller is rotating in what? In anti-clockwise direction, we can see, with angular velocity omega. So we can get at inlet, after the V1, we will get the first of all the U1. Okay, that is the tangential velocity. Then we know that this V1 is resultant of the relative velocity and U1. Okay, so we have to complete this triangle, means U1 is in left hand side or this side and V1 is on this side. So V1 is the resultant. So V1 is equal to VR1 plus U1 as per the vector law. So the resultant and the component should meet at the single point. So if you consider this V1 direction is anti-clockwise direction, then U1 and VR1 are in anti-clockwise direction. So clockwise and anti-clockwise direction meet at this particular point. So this inlet velocity triangle get completed. And we know that in every turbo machine, the fluid, that may be your water or that may be the air, in this case the fluid is air, is tight with the vane with the VR1 component, means that is relative velocity, and leave the vane with the VR2 component initially. Again, this impeller is rotating in anti-clockwise direction, so after the VR2 we are getting the first of all the U2, that is a tangential velocity component. Then VR2 and U2, again the component of the V2, means absolute velocity of air at the outlet. So V2 is equal to U2 plus VR2. So this VR2 and U2 are moving in anti-clockwise direction, and this V2, which is the result one, will be moving in a clockwise direction, and they will meet at a single point. So we will get first of all this triangle. Okay, and again we know that there is a flow velocity component which is a perpendicular direction. We can just draw the perpendicular line. From the outlet point, we will get the V2 component, and there may be chances of the whirling, physically whirling action, okay, at the outlet of the impeller. So you will get the VW2 also. So this is the complete velocity triangle at the outlet. Remaining things, that is alpha, theta, phi and beta, uses the nomenclature which are we are using in the previous units also. Okay, there is no change in the nomenclature. This is a complete velocity triangle. Okay, normally in ideal condition it is expected that this VR2 is equal to VF2. So whatever the air is at this particular outlet, that should be leave the impeller in a perpendicular direction only, but due to the slip phenomenon we are getting this kind of velocity triangle, and this is the same velocity triangle we have got in case of the centrifugal pump also. The slip thing or slip phenomenon we are going to discuss separately in next upcoming slides. Okay, I hope that you understood that this velocity triangle. Next one, we have to find out what is the work done and mass flow rate of the air in a centrifugal compressor. These are the system, The centrifugal compressor is a system in which some vanes are mounted on a wheel. So we have to go for the torque. Okay. So as per this law, torque in the direction of the motion of the blade is equal to the rate of change of angular momentum. So change of angular momentum means what? Final moment, angular momentum minus initial angular momentum. We know that my angular momentum generally given as m dot v and r, means mvr. In this case, we have to take the m dot, which is a constant one as per the continuity principle. Then we have to take the velocity component, and we know that in every turbo machines, work done causes due to what? Power input or power output, or work done input or output can causes due to which component? It is by the whirling component. So final whirling component, that is Vw2, and you have to take the radius, that is the final means outlet radius. So we will get the m dot Vw2 R2 minus m dot Vw1 R1, final angular momentum minus initial angular momentum. And we know that Vw is equal to 0. The simplified form of the torque equation will get torque is equal to m dot Vw2 R2 newton meter. Now the rate of change of energy transfer or angular velocity omega is given. So work done per second is equal to power is equal to torque into omega. So m dot Vw2 R2 using equation number 6.14 into omega. Again, we can simplify this equation. We know that this R omega stands for the U. So R2 omega stands for the U2. So we will get the work done per second is equal to power is equal to m dot Vw2 U2 watts. So work done per kg, if you divided by m dot, again we will get the W is equal to Vw2 U2, because some of the cases we have to find out the work done using the means you have to find out the work done per kg also. So you have to just divide the mass over here. Okay. So next we have to calculate the mass flow rate. These are the given data over here. We can take this capital B1 and capital B2 also, width at or height of impeller blade at inlet and outlet respectively. This is small V1 and small V2. We have to take it as specific volume of air at inlet and specific volume at air at outlet in meter cube per kg. Then we have to define the density also, 1 upon specific volume as per definition, kg per meter cube. So mass flow rate we can given as basic formula, m dot is equal to rho into q. So rho can be given as 1 upon specific volume into q, and this q, that is discharge, can be given as area into flow velocity. So mass can be written as area of flow into flow velocity upon specific volume. So how we can calculate the area of the flow here, flow over here? We can calculate the area of flow given by the circumferential area into width. So 2 pi r1 is a circumference, and to b1, that is width at inlet. So flow velocity at outlet into flow velocity at inlet, that is v1 upon specific volume at inlet, is equal to 2 pi r2 b2 circumferential area at outlet into flow velocity at outlet divided by specific volume at outlet. So this is without considering the thickness of the vanes. And if you consider the thickness of the vanes, okay, if n number of vanes are blades are there, and if you consider the T is the thickness of each of the blade, then we have to means we have to reduce that area from the circumferential area. So we can write, instead of 2 pi r1, we can write the 2 pi r1 minus n into T into b1 into v upon v1 is equal to 2 pi R2 minus NTB2 into V2 upon V2. This is a similar concept that we are using Francis turbine also, or centrifugal pump also. Got it? So this is a mass flow rate equation. Now, which is the next part, which is very important, that is performance parameters. The first one we are going to discuss the slip factor. Okay. So basically, I already told you that we should get the outlet velocity, that is V2 is equal to V2, where we are getting the different triangle at the outlet velocity triangle. We should have the different triangles. Means you should get this VR2 is equal to VF2. Means you should get the Vw2 V2, means Vw2 is equal to 0. But we are getting this kind of triangle due to the slip phenomenon. Now we are going to discuss what is the slip. Slip basically is the difference between the U2 velocity and whirling component of velocity. Means again we can say the smallest recirculation of the air around the blade, it's called as a slip. Okay. We know that the in centrifugal compressor we are having the aerofoil kind of blade, which is used to compress the air, or which is used to impart the energy to the air. Due to the aerofoil shape, what will happen? There is a region near the blade, in which region at the one edge we are having the higher pressure and at the another edge we are having the lower pressure of the air. So the small recirculating flow around the blade is taken place, means like this. Okay, due to what? There is a pressure variation. At this side everywhere there is a less pressure, and at this side there is a high pressure, and due to the low pressure the air get lifted up here. Due to the high pressure again they are getting push down towards the blade. So we are getting the small recirculatory flow around this particular vane, and this small recirculation increases the work input to the compressor for the same compression ratio, to compress the same amount of air. Okay, means if you are getting the 100% of air flow, 100 meter cube per kg or 100 meter cube per second air at the compressor at the outlet of the compressor, but due to small resolution of the flow around each of the blade, we are getting the only 98 or 99 meter cube per second air. And to if you having the need of the 100 meter cube per second air only, then you have to supply the extra amount of work to the compressor to get that same amount of air. Okay, means this kind of some loss occurs over here due to the small recirculation of the air, and this recirculation of the air occurs due to the blade curvature. Okay, and there is a pressure variation. Okay, so this recirculation of air is called as a slip, and it is defined as U2 minus VW2, and the slip factor also defined as VW2 by U2, and slip factor is usually less than 1. Means if you consider, basically this work done by the impeller on the centrifugal compressor is called as the Euler work, and this Euler work is given as E by M, means work done per kg mass. So VW2 U2, and if you put this sigma factor over here, then you will get the work done or Euler work is equal to sigma U2 square. So basically there is increasing work due to the slip. Okay, so we are having the impeller formula for the slip also. It is called as the Stannis formula. Okay, sigma is given as 1 minus 0.63 times pi upon n, where n is the number of the blade. If the number of blades are increasing, the slip factor getting increases, because if number of blades are increases, this ratio getting decreases, and if this ratio is getting decreases, 1 minus it comes out less than 1, so we will get the sigma approaches to the 1. That's why if number of blades are increasing, sigma also getting increases, and we should not have this increasing sigma. We should decrease the slip factor, so work input or losses will be less. So if number of blades are decreasing, number of blades are increasing, this ratio is getting increases. If this ratio is getting increases, maybe this ratio is more than 1, so slip factor is less than 1, so slip factor getting decreases. So this is a Stannis formula to understand the slip. Okay.